What can you do, boys? Well, you can do it any kind. What do you want to do? You like pull weeds?
Let's, yeah.
Let's pull some weeds. Let's clean over here a little bit. You see all the weeds? You see all the weeds over here, Laiva?
Yeah.
All this kind, you got a hammer.
Get that thing. Those
things. Oh, legend. We'll go hammer some of these weeds. We'll go clear all this. We'll go to tarot. See all the work on the weeds.
Uncle, what
are we hooking leaves, Uncle?
Yeah, this column only hooking only the grass.
What?
Only
the grass? Yeah, only pula pula yet. We gotta wait for the tarot to get big. Yeah, just throw them in on plow right now. Planted.
Yeah.
We're gonna have to wait 9 months. 9 months is when it will be fully matured. And when you guys come back, we'll go hook you up. But all along the way, we're gonna take care. That's why all this kind of stuff. This kind you can cut, and then you bring them over here and you cover them. Cover the ground.
Okay.
Because you're gonna keep the ground moist. See all the banana leaf over there? See all the banana leaf over there? That banana leaf. Oh, you know what? tell, you can tell it's the kind. It won't be long. Public enemy number two.
Just like we did yesterday.
That was good fun, huh?
Yeah.
Right, real stuff. You get something for sure. Not just plain. Bombay the taro gon' grow and you're gonna have something for feed the family. Feed the ohana boy. Bombay, when you like make lao lao or luau, you can come pick the luau leaf.
What you help do, you help you get.
Huh?
What you help do, you get some of it.
Oh, roger that, you know already, when you kokua, you're gonna be eating. Yeah, boy, that's the one. Hey, good job. That's all you did. You say, covering him up, yeah, so one by when the sun gonna come, he gonna... All this banana leaf gonna keep the ground nice and moist. And when you break down too, it feeds the soil, feeds the awa, so the next thing you know, the awa can come all big and strong, and then when we come over here for hamo the root, we're gonna have a big root ball.
And uncle, good, because when it rains, all the rain is gonna come down into there.
Yeah, it collects all, and even at nighttime, all the dew, you know how I get dew at night? All the dew gonna collect all on the leaf, let out, and then morning time, it's all gonna just go inside the lepo.
Yeah.
Feed the plant, feed the roots.
Finally, you guys are coming help. Are you guys gonna help or are you gonna stand there?
Oh.
Yeah, right, bro.
Alright, boy, you ready for the Minahuni action? It's gonna be dark pretty soon. You like Minahuni actions, huh?
From my house.
Oh, that's mine. Nice one, yeah? Oh, careful, huh? Shut the machete shop, boy.
I work with machetes all day.
Do you?
Yeah, right. I chop down trees in my dad's backyard.
Hey, we love that. We love that, Kohana.
But sharper.
Yeah, you gotta make sharp, yeah, boy.
And you can use stones to make it sharp.
And boy, you know how they tell? If no more water, go find the water and bring them. Put them inside the lo'i. No more water, put the water inside the lo'i. Because you know the Kanakas, you have the right to the water, no matter where you go. So no scared, go get the water, feed the turtle patch. It's the army right here. This is the up and coming warriors right here. The Kamali of Wainiha. Mumbai, these guys gonna be, they're gonna be in the lo'i planting and they're gonna be the ones taking on the torch too of our kuleana. Huh, boy? What you need them for your bike?
Yeah.
Take a look in the white bucket on the right side of the hale. Leiva, where you go? How are they too? Oh, you Akamai, yeah?
All the teachers say so, sound so sweet when they
I know.
They say like
Miss Ko'o.
Yeah, like,
a hula cow.
That's
what you need. Oh! You need Kokua, boy?
No need.
Next one, we go the kind. You guys gotta come back more early in the day, and then we can the kind jam all kinds.
Tomorrow we can jam all day and all night.
Kayo, I see you later, Levaya. Bye.
Wait.
The Kamali'i. It's a blessing to have them. love having the kids around us. They're definitely why we stay doing this, to make sure that they always gonna have one place. Cause if they gonna take all these places away from us, then not gonna be one concrete jungle like Oahu. And this is the garden island, supposed to have gardens everywhere.
So those are the Keiki of Wainiha that live around here, huh?
Yeah, they live right down the road. It's all like Pule, Ohana, and Chandler boys, some of the Chandlers, which is all Mauwiki, Ohana, and but all family. It's all the Keiki from around. They all live down the road, and they all go school, Hanalei school, but yeah, they always come ride their bikes up here and the kind. And they always come check us out in the lo'i, come check us out, and usually me and Kalimi, we try to influence them and put them to work where they should be inside, you know, getting connected with their roots and whatnot. And we just try and keep them rooted and just give them that proper place where they always make that energy for them like that, where it's always open and welcome for them to come over here. They're always welcome for come over here anytime. And we love that. We when we see them come, oh, I come haole when I see the boys come. Because that's the very boys should be inside the lo'i over here learning and whatnot. Because there's the, you know, the up and coming from this place. And they gotta learn the real thing. And that's why us guys, we try to perpetuate the real thing and not the kind perpetuate the uku. We gotta, you know, we got a mālama our kuleana, and it goes all the way to our keiki and then some.
So those being the keiki of Wainiha from the families, from the ohanas of Wainiha, and them growing up here and you know, and then learning from you folks about the practices that might be unique to Wainiha and actually connecting with the land, you think that's valuable?
Oh, I think that's so valuable. That's like something money cannot buy, or you know, it's beyond valuable. It's so precious that, you know, just the lifestyles that our kupuna had laid down for us, and it's so special. And we're so fortunate to be able to grow up here and just live in this place and learn and just share our life with the world, because you know we get plenty for offer. And yeah, it's very valuable that we keep that alive for our keiki, and we don't can let them slip into a westernized world of things, because that's going to be the downfall of our people. And we gotta keep them culturally grounded and just keep their roots alive, and just, you know, they gotta know where they come from and their ancestors before them for know how they can go forward in Holomua. So yeah, it's very important.
Have you seen what can happen to young kane who don't have that kind of ʻāina to connect to and don't have that kind of cultural mentorship?
Yeah, I you know, me, I raised up in Kohala, Hawī from Moko Keawe, and you know, I've been around those hardships myself when I was a youth, like getting caught up in the drug scene and just caught up in the wrong crowd. And because for myself growing up, I never had taro patch for be able to go play inside or any, a lot of these cultural things that well ground us, they weren't available. So just for when I was young, I found myself going out and just doing all the wrong kinds of things, because never have land for, or just never have place for us. And you know, and over here, yeah, for this generation, I, like, you know, I don't, like, see them going down a similar route that I've been through. Like, you know, when they hit high school and whatnot, and all the, they stay around the scene with the drugs and whatnot, they gotta know already, like, that's gonna be the ultimate downfall of themselves, of their ohana. That's what the system like us to. They like us through the drugs. They like us drink their alcohol so that we can be all jam up and not address the kuleana. The system don't want us to be out here planting taro and being kanaka. They try and force us to be American, and at the same time they have all these problems in society that's just keeping everybody distracted from the real thing and just keeping everybody in their way of things, where they got a lock on everybody, from whether it be from healthcare or the education system or just all around how they controlling our whole livelihood with the money and taxation of things. And it's very, very important that we address all these matters now before it's gonna be almost too late. You know, just here in Kauai, the Garden Island, it's already, in this last 10 years, I watched it change so much. So much more people still over here, so much traffic. And don't get me wrong, I'm aware that there's billions of people in this world, and this world is growing. But how the hell are we supposed to feed all those billions of people in the world if they can take away the resources of the wettest place in the world and whatnot? And you know, the Garden Island, one of the most, at one point in time, we were so sustainable, we were feeding millions of people and then some. And yeah, it's very important that we make sure that our ʻāina, our water, is gonna be here forever for all the generations. And definitely, you know, for the unborn, that's where we thinking of too, for the unborn, for the keiki. From growing up, even just in Kohala, before I came to Kauai, I watched my ohana, kanaka ohana, get displaced from their land they grew up on, and then have to stay in a tent on the side of a gulch and just have struggling at all levels, no money, no job, no car. Just in this modern world of things, no way to get around and do things. And no, it's just sad for see that. And yeah, over here too, you know, it's just happening on the biggest scale of things, you know. There's been so much Hawaiian ohanas that got there, like, if you came here back in the, just even in the 70s and 80s, like, all the ohanas were still, like, doing pretty good, thriving. They all, like, every ohana had their own lo'i. We're in a kind of a mess of things that we gotta fix on all kinds of levels, not just here in Hawaii, but you go to our beaches, you get plastics washing up on our beach coming from who knows where, from Japan or wherever. So this goes beyond. This is us as earth warriors. Like, we've, you know what I mean? We all connected just through Te Moana Nui, through the big ocean. And if we get all kind of plastics and stuff washing up on our beaches over here, that is one big problem. And you know, that's why on collective consciousness as a whole, as the people of the planet, we need to start waking up and addressing these problems that is going to affect everybody. Nowadays, with all these so-called foreigners moving here and building their big vacation rentals and their multi-million dollar homes on beachfront, the kind of ʻāina, and as well as all the hotels and everything, it's just making our land taxes go so skyrocketing. Most of the ohanas, they can't even afford to pay their land taxes. Like, good grief. How the families can hold on to their land? They're getting taxed, like, on arm and on leg and on head for just pay taxes on the land. And the families are, everybody's just getting taxed on all levels. Taking their lives is being stolen. We're being poisoned. All the kind of food they feed us in the stores, all this processed food from America, genetically modified, engineered, whatever food, it's all poisoning us, slowly poisoning us. And me, I don't like eating none of that food. I like know where my food coming from. I like go harvest my own food. I like grow my own food. I like catch my own food. And we all should be on that level. We should we got to encourage each other to get back in somewhat of a bartering system. You know, hey, you over there, you the fisherman. Hey, I the kalo guy. What? We can trade. I give you some taro. I like try some eat off of eat. That's how Hawaiian style, just trade. And everybody gets something for bring to the table. But, you know, yes, Hawaiians are still to this day in 2017 being displaced from their ʻāina. And no can already. That's where we are at now. Our ʻohana, me, my hoʻaloha, all of our, you know, our who we are around us. We taking on stand. We over it already. We don't have nowhere to go. So if they take us away from here, we gonna be down the beach, putting up tent, putting up the hammock, camping. Pretty much, I don't want to say homeless, but houseless. No more one house, no more one hale. No can afford. So, you know, and then that's the problem too. They see Hawaiians living down at the beach and that, and you know, whatever, just because they have nowhere else to go. And then they call them, oh, it's a homeless, look at all these homeless people. But no Kanaka moli, no Hawaiian should ever be homeless in the Pai ʻAina of Hawaii. What is wrong with that picture? Why we get homeless people? Listen to mo'o, they say it, communicating to us over there. Because, you know, they know too. And our kupuna knows, and that's why all the truth is being coming out right now, is being revealed. And you know, can hide the truth. And definitely the heaven not going to prevail. What going prevail is the porno actions. And, you know, for me, I feel in my now that what we're doing here is porno. And that's all we really can try to do is perpetuate the ʻAina in righteousness. You know, ua mau ke ea o ka ʻAina I ka pono. They say that in their own motto, but then yet, are they really perpetuating what is righteous by putting all these septic tanks and houses in our taro patches and displacing the kanaka from the ʻAina and taking our vai? I don't know. Words is power, and they telling that in their own the kind system. More like they stay lying, and that thing on the kind bound back on them, and that's why. Huli the system. We gonna huli them, cause they is in the wrong. They not porno. I refuse to die, and I refuse to let them kill me or kill us. So you know, we not gonna let them do that to us. We gonna go all the way. This is why Keakua put me on this earth. I gonna dedicate my whole life to the Lahui and to the ʻAina and to our Ibi Kupuna and to the kingdom, and just to bettering, because if without us, without the kingdom, without the Lahui, then we're a vital role in the whole like movement of the world as a collective consciousness and the whole of the whole the kind, the whole world around us. You know, we all special, we all important, and every culture is special, important, and they all need to be preserved in the kind. Why are they putting all the money into war? Why do we really need to go to Middle East or whatever? That, to me, they make everybody believe what they like them believe. They put all this kind of stuff on the media and whatnot, and they think, oh, terrorism this, terrorism that. But who is the real terrorist? You got these guys coming over here and arresting Kanakas for just being people, for just making food. To me, they're the terrorists. They coming over here. That is terrorism. You stay doing that to your own people in your so-called own country. You look at Standing Rock. Look at all the Indians over there. You stay trying to cross one of the main river supplies with an oil pipeline that is potentially gonna broke and poison and the kind mess up everyone's water. And then you got the government over there supporting them and militarizing, brutal police brutality. They stay arresting all the Indian, all our Kanakas over there. They stay shooting them with rubber bullets. They stay, you know, pepper spraying them, and just on all kinds of levels, no more respect. And so how can we respect our system when they no more respect for us? So, you know, for all those people who think like, yeah, you should be like a normal person and go work and go out there and get a job and pay taxes like the rest of the society. But so what? Pay taxes so that you can go bomb some more people. You know what I mean? All your money is only going to war. Why are I going to pay taxes so they can go make more nuclear warheads and poison and destroy us? Oh, ole. I don't know about you guys, but more better we spend our time and our energy actually making what's our life around us pono, making our food and our water abundant and just whatever. Just we cannot be having them run our lives. We have the right to self-determination and where our lives are going and, you know, who governs us and whatever. And so, you know, that being said, we're sovereign. This is our sovereignty. We food sovereign. And, you know, they cannot take that away from us as much as they try. But, you know, we work hard every day. We trying for work. We just not like everybody. We don't get paid for go work. But we out here, we trying for clean the ʻāina and bring back the abundance and just clean up all the overgrown opala and all this evasive species that come over here and they're taking all over our natives. It's very symbolic to what's happening to the Kanaka natives. You got all these weeds and stagnant evasive trees overtaking all the native and endemic indigenous species. And it's same thing over here. All the Kanakas, they say, all getting overcrowded by all these foreigners and evasives. And then they say getting taken over. And, you know, we gotta come and cut all the weeds. We gotta hammer all the weeds out of the garden and thrive. Let the haloa thrive. Because, you know, that's how we all gonna thrive. Haloa. We all haloa nakas. Haloa lao la. Haloa lao kapalili o kikoa. You know, it's the reflection of the shimmering of the taro leaf is like it's a reflection of the warrior's energy. And if haloa stay all jam up and overgrown and whatnot, then that is one reflection of how we are in society and where we're at with things. The whole world stay looking at us and laughing and wondering, ha, what's going on with those Americans over there? But us, we not American. We Kanaka Moli. We come from the Kingdom of Hawaii. From Polynesia, we Polynesians. And, you know, the kind. That's why the hell we gonna go listen to a government that's not even our government? We get our own government that they had occupy us and they arrest our queen and hold her hostage in Iolani Palace, and then they kill off all our people, all our ʻohanas and bloodlines. But they never kill us all, because we still stay here. And, you know, we definitely not going to... We're not going to sell out. Aipuhaku, we'd rather eat the stone than take you guys greedy money. And that's where we stay.